Brad Ferentz in the penalty box in Long Island. The missile, that's the bottle. Brad Isbister in the white, 15. Now they're going to come over. It's one of those classic, a classic old-time sort of a in-your-barn kind of battle. And people are just trying to get out of the way.
In tonight's game, this lady, every time there's a penalty to Detroit, she gets in the face of everybody. Sergei Fedorov doesn't pay attention. But last game, Brendan Shanahan had enough. Same lady on the right side. Sometimes subtlety is the best response. We haven't had Brendan back in the penalty box tonight, but we'll see what happens.
That was a beauty.
We hadn't seen that. Well,
this young man, he's a talker. There's no getting around it, and he is not shy. You're going to watch the Avalanche players come into the penalty box to serve a penalty. He's a waiver. He's trying to say, hey,
he's a waiver.
How you doing? What's going on? He's going to have a little look. You know, hey, I'm trying a little different approach right there. Now he's going to look and see exactly what are these guys drinking down here? What's going on? And finally, Andrew, get him. A wave. Yeah, my night is made. You know, my night is made. My favorite.
What
player.
A seat, though.
I know. Oh, I know. Those just spectacular. But, you know, but he was just talking to his. I mean, he just never stopped talking and waving.
Tough game, no matter where you are. You got to fight the traffic. You got to fight a lot of problems as David Moss comes out of the booth, the penalty box, I should say, the terrarium of inequity. He loses his glove, and he turns, looks back. The gate's already shut. It's like the subway car's leaving. I got to get to the bench. He stayed out on the ice.
It's a morning, yeah. What a fucking joke!
Still down on the ice, Domi, he's going to the box for 2 minutes, unsportsmanlike conduct, and this is where it gets dicey. His fans were throwing stuff at him, so he gives a squirt over the glass. Tucker being helped off. Another squirt, and here comes a fan from the second row, Chris Falcone. Down he goes, glass breaks, and now we have a fracas. Domi and the fan going at it. Again, NHL cannot be pleased with this. Falcone needed stitches because he was cut. Cops hauled him off and he was given a citation. There you see him. Domi is helped out of the box, then back into the box, served his penalty minutes, security keeping everybody out, and was back.
I always get the feeling Kevin Bieksa loves this kind of hockey. All five skaters on the ice, both teams get 5 minutes for fighting. So after all that, we're going to stay 5-on-5.
I think we're in for an entertaining afternoon. Boxing with the chance, it just goes off to the right side of Rene. And then it starts up again. So a little bit of pushing and shoving. Get that part of the game started. We can see that coming along. And then it's Subban and Foxa. Subban takes that first punch with the glove on, and all of a sudden he drops the gloves. He got the initial one. I would imagine he'll get the front extra two. And then the guy we talk about having some character jumps in for him. They try to sort all this out.
I think they've switched benches to the other side of the ice here.
Only 45 seconds into the hockey game here.
Well, Pete Laviolette, the head coach of the Nashville Predators, was none too thrilled with his team's effort here yesterday.
And the referee's still trying to sort out. It's everyone on the ice in the box right now. There's five in the box for Winnipeg.
They're going to run out of room
and
in there.
Five for the Predators. It's a full house.
I don't think they have the seating capacity. As cops sitting up on the boards. And one more time, there's the whistle right there, and there's a good two steamboats gone, and right away, Fisher's in, Ellison, Wilson's in, and the Winnipeg Jets, you can see the frustration, you can see the anger. This is not what they thought would come tonight against the Nashville Predators. And
look at the penalty box. Six in the box for the Predators. The Jets, Phil, they've got five. That's 11 players
on one side of the ice right now, and that's given a lot of room to both benches on the other side.
It's getting kind of full over there inside the Flyers penalty box.
We'll take a look where this penalty comes, and you get your stick up. Shaw's not happy as he destroys that stick in the box. You see the frustration. You're battling. You're trying to extend plays. And Shaw gets that stick parallel. Sometimes you get away with it at the end of games. Sometimes you don't. This time Shaw doesn't. He doesn't like the call.
Jonathan Marchessault not so happy there as he was serving the extra minor and he's trying to get out of the penalty box. Decides he's going to do it on his own. He gets a little help from Perron, but they say no. So that's what the confusion was over there. And you can see Marchessault, he was serving the extra, allowed to come out with time, ran out, but they thought differently inside there. But the good thing is there's no harm done.
Check by Pessin. He gets slammed on the boards by Kadri. And then Matheson hits Kadri. Puck is out to center. Balassiwa after
now.
Now
he's going to get it for Belly.
Yeah. We've got Kadri and Matheson going at it and some poles.
You
got
to get Kadri going as well for retaliating. You've got to make this an even call. I think Matheson's going to go, right?
It may only be one call to Nazem Kadri as he slams his stick, and he's hearing an earful from the NHL official in the box. You do not see that very often.
No, you certainly don't.
Well, this is what playoffs are about. I mean, you see this same team over and over again, time after time, especially in pretty tight quarters, tight hockey, overtime games, and you're going to see plenty of this kind of extracurriculars when a score finally does get separated by three or four goals.
McLeod and Veilleux still going back and forth at each other.
Well, they'll take a little while to sort this one out.
Veilleux making fun of the teeth or lack thereof of McLeod. it's getting personal.
Yeah, you know what though? I mean, you can make fun of a lot of guys that way.
Oh boy, it's deteriorated to this.
The ill will started behind the net when Harper high-stick Pulford. After a brief scuffle, matters cooled until the combatants resumed jousting near the Canadiens' bench. They dropped their gloves and Pulford proceeded to drop Harper with a right hand. Eventually, they were escorted across the ice to the penalty box, which, in the NHL of 1963, was a shared space. The only neutral parties were doorkeepers, often retirees who would never be mistaken for, say, nightclub bouncers. The attendants generally sat next to the penalized players, not between them. Harper will not reveal precisely what was said as they settled in the box, but admits words were exchanged. Pulford leaped up and attacked Harper, all under the gimlet glare of a national midweek audience on CTV, and NHL President Clarence Campbell, whose seat at the Gardens was adjacent to the penalty box. The startling thing was not that Harper and Pulford had brawled in the penalty box, but that something like this didn't happen regularly. Toronto President Stafford Smythe conceded, "It's ridiculous to ask two guys who've been trying to knock each other's heads off to sit quietly side by side." On November 8th, 10 days after the stink that changed the rink, the reconfigured Gardens unveiled the NHL's first separate penalty boxes. The Montreal Forum quickly followed. And for the 1965-66 season, the NHL, a stride behind the play, decreed, quote, "It would be preferable if there were separate penalty benches for each team."